visiting San Antonio Friday. Good news all the way around for the Spurs. Tony Parker's back in action after missing the last eight with an ankle injury. And Tim Duncan just 3 rebounds away from passing Shaquille O'Neal on the all-time rebounds list. Well, you asked for 3. You're going to get 3. Tim Duncan going to work on the glass in the first quarter. And off the Al Jefferson miss, right here, Duncan gets the rebound, giving him 13,100 for his career, passing Shaq. In the second quarter, Mo Williams can get the runner to go. He had 23 points to lead Utah. They led 41-38 at halftime, a season low for points and a half for San Antonio. But Duncan comes out, Duncan, in the third. 19 points, 16 rebounds for him. And Paul Millsap comes up with a steal and the dunk on the other end. Utah had a 2-point lead entering the fourth at 65-63. Manu Ginobili in the fourth, missing the three. Tiago Splitter with the rebound, and he finds Kawhi Leonard. Kawhi had 21 points. The Spurs on top by 1. And it's Kanter coming up with a steal now. Mo Williams to Derek Favors over Matt Bonner, and the foul on the Red Rocket. Derek doing Matt Bonner no favors on that play. Tony Parker, that's vintage. The floater is good. And now Jefferson for Utah comes right back. 18 points, 13 rebounds for him. Utah by a bucket. Tied at 85 now. Parker finds Kawhi in the corner for 3. It's 88-85 with just over a minute to play. 8.5 left in regulation. Jazz down by 3. And they swing it to Marvin Williams, who's open in the corner. Ball fake. And he knocks it down. Tying it at 90 right at the buzzer. Marvin got Manu to bite on the fake, giving him a wide open look. So we head to free basketball in San Antonio. In the extra session, Manu atoning for the defensive miscue by knocking down a 3-ball, 98-95 Spurs. Then Parker picking up right where he left off before the injury, looking good.
Duncan faces up Big Al, rolls it in left hand. Catches a rim, he'll shoot one.
Big Al picks up his second foul, and Tim Duncan.
Splitter, Duncan on the dish. Tim Duncan with 15.
Now, I don't think Coach Corbin wanted Mo to follow Tony Parker over the top of that screen. I think he wants him to go underneath. Tony was in there. What's up?
Tony looked like he had things to beat out there tonight.
You know, Tony, we've been waiting for him to get back. I think the training staff and coach staff did a great job with pulling him in the mound and giving him time to heal fully before he came back. But, you know, especially down the stretch in 4 quarters, it's good having him out there. It was a relief for all of us to have him back.
I think it's going to take some time here over the next couple weeks to get back in that rhythm you guys were in before Tony went down.
Nah. Because we have a professional team. We have like guys that's going to get prepared, that's going to be ready to play. And at the end of the day, we know our identity. And it's defensive first. We know who our stars are. We know who our role players are. So it's just all about us going out there and doing it.
Do you think you've gotten back to that the last couple games, defense?
Defense has been on and off. We haven't been consistent with it. And that's what we want to get consistent before the playoffs. That's our main goal right now. We can score points. We just got to knock down shots. But defense is what we hang our hat on.
What do you think about facing the Rockets on Sunday
night? It's always fun playing against a high-scoring team like that. They're fighting for playoff position, so we got to go out there and play our game. We're getting ready for the playoffs. We're not trying to just look at games and have them pass by. We want to continue to win and be solid come playoff time.
Paul's not a big milestone guy, but
900. It's funny. I played for Don Nelson when he broke the record, and I'm playing. You know, I'm back with Pop, so I'm happy for Pop. He deserves it. Pretty sure he got many more to come. He pushed the cake in my face, and it should have been his face, but because we'd had a cake for him. But I'm happy for him. I'm happy to be a part of him. I'm happy to say I was able to be coached and played by Coach Popovich. It's been a pleasure, and hopefully we can win more games for him.
Teams like Houston and Utah that are fighting for their lives, like you say.
Very dangerous. But, you know, Houston is a dangerous team anyway. They got some great scores. And like you say, they're trying to get in the playoffs. So, I mean, every team that play us looks at us as like we want to beat the best team in the league, and we got to go out there and be prepared to hold it down.